into a sunken town, a handsome gambler ran. For he owed gold and blood, and yet had none to spare. Desperate and forlorn, he was about to change his path and walk away, when he heard a song that called on him to chance his luck again. Now the singer was a creature with the biggest mouth the gambler had ever seen. "Excuse my song," the monstrous siren said. "The tune's purpose was your attention. For I knew you had troubles, and I can offer absolutions." "Can you carry me from this bind?" the youth asked. "Boy, the world's one river, and I'm its king. Ain't no place I ain't been. Ain't no place I can't go again. And the price is a minuscule thing. See, I got hungers that ain't easily fed. But those finest tables, they ain't never got a seat for me. So I need men like yourself to let me in." Now the gambler's only hunger was dice and cards, so this bargain, it seemed too easy a price. "If you're offering a ticket," the youth finally said, "that's a deal I will take." And before another word was spoke, the monster snapped him up and fled. To a faraway land the gambler was conveyed. At a palace of chance he was left. Years passed, and love the gambler found. His bride, a princess, and the wedding, none would miss. Now when that hungry beast finally did arise, the family screamed and fought. And although the gambler tried to cast him out, it ate the gifts, and house, and gold. For its hunger, nothing satisfied.
"Please, not now, not this time," the bride did cry.
The beast's response, to her it purred. "This hunger's a burden, but it's the last time, I swear. So please, forgive." Now the creature's lies, so melodic and sincere, charmed that bride, and thus she failed to recognize when that demon's jaw unhinged. She screamed just once as I snapped her bones and crushed her limbs. Now that meal, it left me satisfied. So cry if you want, boy. 'Cause you had a chance to walk away. Instead, you're the fool who let me in.